I will be telling you everything that you need to know on CapCut project settings. Whenever you open CapCut for the first time, you will get to see all that project. You can just click on any project to begin, or if you want to create a new project, you simply go to create project. We can now proceed by applying the settings that we will be using for our videos. It will be based on the type of content that you want to edit. For reels, then you will have to choose a 9:16 aspect ratio. If it's for long form video, that is landscape or horizontal, you will need to choose 16:9. Before you start to import your files in CapCut, make sure you first adjust the CapCut project settings based on your needs. Click on this modify at the top right corner of your screen. These are the details of the current project, like it's a default one when you just open CapCut or you open a new project. You have here the name to be 0121. It's not what we want. We have the path where we want to save our project. We have the original aspect ratio. So it will take everything the way you bring it if you don't modify all these settings. So I will click on modify. I want to type the name based on the project that I'm working with. I will type there CapCut project settings, for example, and I will go down. Where do I want to import? Imported. The imported files should stay in the original location. I don't want to copy media to project. The aspect ratio now is original. Original means it will take the aspect ratio based on the video, that is like the first video that you place on your timeline. It will take it to be the original aspect ratio if at all you don't modify all these settings. I can choose 16:9, and they say resolution is adapted. Is adapted here means the resolution can still be 4K, can be a 4K video, because a 4K video will also have that aspect ratio of 16:9. If I want to work on a 1920x1080p video, then I will go to this drop menu, I go to custom, and then I apply the ones that I want to work with. If you are working on something like reels, then you will have to switch this 1080x1920 because it's the opposite of landscape video. What frame rate do you want to work with, or what frame rate did you shoot your videos? It's up to 60 fps, and the color space I will maintain. This one is like the default. After the details, you go to performance. Here you want your editing to be smooth, so it should be faster, because if the video is too heavy, it's gonna be maybe lagging. It's a way for you or for your project's editing to be smoother. Turn it on to edit smoothly and faster without losing video quality. Turn it on, go to save. If I place this vertical video down here on my timeline, I will get this. You see, the borders are black. The borders are black because the video resolution is smaller than that of our project setting. If I bring this other one, you see it will occupy the entire screen, as you can see. You see that when working with CapCut, under this, you can't find the details tab again or the details panel again, because we've selected a particular video or we've selected a particular file. So the details of that file will appear at this top right hand corner. But if you click on your timeline on an empty space, that will now bring those details. So let's see what happens. You see, now you can go back again to modify. If you enjoy watching this video, don't forget to like, don't forget to comment, don't forget to subscribe if you are not already a subscriber. Share this video so that other people can benefit. Let me know what you think about this video in the comments. And if you want any video tutorial, feel free to let us know, feel free to request so that we can support you in our next video. We'll be coming with a series of CapCut video tutorials, so stick around, hit on the notification bell so that you don't miss anything. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Armando Vision.